little song called Blue Stew. I take one bucket full of hair like gold, then add two heaping teaspoons of lies you told, just a quarter tears and one half true. Then I'll mix it all up and have some blue stew. Maybe I'll start my own little cooking show, and then I'll be on TV from coast to coast. I say, here is my recipe for lovesick fools, and it's easy to make, I call it blue stew. TV dinners and beer or two, potato chips and the bitter truth. I'm eating blue stew, blue stew. It's hard on the heart, it ain't good for you when you're all alone at a table for two. You're having blue stew. You can't buy it at your local grocery chain. I sell it at my international house of pain. If you're broken hearted, have a bowl or two, 'cause I'm a gourmet chef at cooking blue stew. There ain't no red peppers in that boiling pot, but when you get burned, that's what makes it hot. It's so hard to swallow when your love ain't true, but I get lots of business selling blue stew. I'm eating words you said to me, but I've got a hunger you would not believe. I'm eating blue stew, blue stew. It's hard on the heart, it ain't good for you when you're all alone at a table for two. You had a blue stew with a solo. Canada, we stopped and looked at Niagara Falls, and as I was watching the beautiful rushing water, I thought to myself, Niagara rhymes with Viagra. So I wrote this song about Viagra. And this is not a representation of what I am as an artist. It's just something to kind of loosen us up a little bit. Sip a little wine, you know. And check out what the name of it is. It's called I'm Gonna Go to Viagra Before It Falls. It's pitiful. There was a time when I could make love all night long, like a big rooster in the barnyard, I felt strong. But now my private part needs an emergency jump start. I'm gonna go to Viagra before it falls. Y'all like that? It gets better, watch this. My wife put on a sexy negligee, but I just had to turn the other way. She's so full of frustration, 'cause I can't rise to the occasion. I'm gonna go to Viagra before it falls. I know I'm not the man I used to be, failure with my broke down genitalia. I'm gonna go to Viagra before it falls. I don't wanna brag or nothing, but I'm the only songwriter in the world that's ever rhymed failure with genitalia. This last verse, it sends out a message of hope to the whole world. I know a man who is 96 years old. He poured Viagra in his Jell-O bowl. And now the old women won't leave him alone. He's the king of the nursing home. I'm gonna go to Viagra before it falls. I know I'm not the man I used to be. This sudden lack of manly prowess is killing my self-esteem. Here it comes. But I feel like such a failure with my broke down genitalia. I'm gonna go to Viagra before it falls.
Oh yeah.
Thank you very much. I wrote this little song for my mama. It's called Turnip Greens. Now one evening I was sitting around the house and my telephone rang. It was my mother. She said, son, come on over here and I'm gonna cook you some supper. So I put down my Pop-Tart. And I got my truck and I drove over there. First thing I noticed when I walked in was she had a big old pot of turnip greens on the stove. So I sat down and ate a bunch of it. And then I told y'all how she hooked me up when I left with them Cool Whip bowls. Yeah. Well, I went to see my mama this evening. She was cooking a ton of greens. Mama this evening, and she was cooking a ton of grain. She had some hot buttered cornbread, and I washed it down with a glass of iced tea. She had some butter beans and some good old black eyed peas. Yeah, she has some butter beans, people. And she has some good old black eyed peas, chomp. And you know what else? Everything she had was fresh out of the garden, except for the macaroni and cheese. When I got ready to leave, she put some greens in a Cool Whip bowl. Yeah, now, when I got ready to leave, she put some greens in a Cool Whip bowl, 'cause she knew I wouldn't bring her Tupperware back. She said, now baby, here's some you can take with you, darling. You can heat them up and eat them when you get home. God bless all the mamas. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I got a lot of food songs. I don't even know how to preface it other than to say it's called Butter My Biscuit. Authentic southern cooking is what you do the best. Your Dixie Fried recipes are better than the rest. guess. Those turnip greens and cornbread, they really hit the spot. I'm crazy about your taters and those big old hams you got. But dessert is the best part, and I don't ever miss it. I never leave the table, girl, till you butter my biscuit. One night I got hungry and you were not around, so I went to a drive-thru on the cheating side of town. A lot was on the menu, there was brunettes and blondes, but they couldn't hold a candle, so I kept driving on. You see, artificial margarine ain't ever gonna get it, 'cause I know I got the real thing, girl, when you butter my biscuit. When hunger pains come crashing down, you get it hot and you spread it around. You take off your apron and put away your skillet. I always get satisfied when you butter my biscuit. You love them when they're homemade, you like them from a can. It don't matter how I fix them, you say I'm still your man. I know I've got a good thing, so I ain't gonna risk it. There's nothing like the thrill I get when you butter my biscuit. When hunger pains come crashing down, you get it hot and you spread it around. You take off your apron and put away your skillet. I always get satisfied when you butter my biscuit. Oh, I always get satisfied when you butter my biscuit.
Thank you, man. Thank you, thank you. This is a song I wrote about a girl who left Tupelo, where I live, to try to make it in the big city. It's called Star That Fell Down. I saw Cinderella on Heartache and Vine. She sang a cappella and turned dollars into wine. Through the crowd I heard the melody of Mississippi on my mind. And though no one noticed, I saw a tear fall from her eye. She's like a star that fell down on the wrong side of town. But to me she shines more than all these city lights. Back in Tupelo tonight, something's missing in the sky. Must be a star that fell down. I took her picture standing outside the Hollywood Bowl. She believes that one day they'll come here to see her show. She waited in the fountain among the wishes that others threw in. She didn't have a penny, so I tossed one in. She's like a star that fell down on the wrong side of town. She shines more than all these city lights. Back in Tupelo tonight, something's missing in the sky. Must be a star that fell down. In the city of angels, big dreams die hard. Back home they don't know she's been sleeping in her car. She parks it by payphone. She gets gave the number to a friend of a friend. She's waiting on a ship that ain't ever coming in. She's like a star that fell down on the wrong side of town. But to me, she shines more than all these city lights. Back in Tupelo tonight, something's missing in the sky. Must be a star that fell down. She's like a star that fell down.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
I'm going to take a moment and tell you one historical fact about myself. I used to be a professional boxer. It's a true story. And the highlight of my career was a fight that was televised on USA's Tuesday Night Fight, where I fought a four-time world champion, Roberto Duran. And it's true. And like most fighters who fought Duran, I lost. I got stopped in the seventh round on account of a real bad cut I had over my eye. I couldn't see. But anyway, even though I lost to a better man, it's a great memory for me, and it's something I can, you know, tell about in my golden years. And it's also something I can put in a song. The whole song is not about the fight, only the last verse. The other two verses, one is about my 12-year stint in a chair factory, and the other one's about a girlfriend I had that cheated on me 151 times. It's called, that's my wife over there. She, as far as I know, she ain't cheated on me once. But we only been married 7 months, so I better not get too arrogant about it. This song is appropriately titled, "I'd Rather Be a Hammer Than a Nail." My boss man said you better get to work before I have to let you go. He just walks around and he pays no mind to the sweat dripping off of my nose. But after 12 long years of him dogging me out, there's one thing I've learned. Well, I'd rather be a hammer. My girlfriend, she went out on me 151 times. At least she was honest enough to admit it when she wasn't too busy lying. But I came to a realization the last time she kicked my tail. I'd rather be a hammer than a nail. If you've ever been on the receiving end, then you know what it's like. A losing situation has been the story of my life. But I ain't gonna let it beat me down, and someday I'll prevail. Yes, I will. I'd rather be a hammer than a nail. Y'all know what I'm talking about. All right, this is that part I was telling y'all about. Talks about the fight. I climbed in the ring with Roberto Duran, and the punches began to rain down. He hit me with a dozen hard uppercuts, and my corner threw in the towel. I asked him why he had to knock me out, and he summed it up real well. He said, I'd rather be a hammer than a nail. If you've ever been on the receiving end, then you know what it's like. A losing situation has been the story of my life. But I ain't gonna let it beat me down, and someday I'll prevail. Yes, I will. I'd rather be a hammer than a nail.
very much.
There's this young lady I sort of grew up with, and we played together as children and everything. And her family was all Jehovah's Witness. And before I go any further, I don't have nothing against the Jehovah's Witness. God bless them all. They're wonderful people. When she grew up and got out on her own, she became a stripper. And she makes more money than I make. And she drives a big old car. And anyway, I wrote this song about her. And usually when I sing this song, I have my kazoo. But I left my kazoo at home accidentally. So I'm going to have to imitate a kazoo as I sing Joni the Jehovah Witness Stripper. She drives a new car, wears expensive blouses. She tells her mama she's cleaning houses. She goes out witnessing, doing the Lord's work all week. But on the weekend, she's making ends meet. Joni, the Jehovah Witness stripper, put $1 in her G-string and she'll deliver. If her daddy only knew, he'd probably kill her. Joni, the Jehovah Witness stripper. One night down at the club, her daddy walked in. He didn't recognize his daughter dancing. She wore a blonde wig, he had sunglasses. When she got naked, he started clapping. Joni, the Jehovah Witness stripper, put $1 in her G-string and she'll deliver. If her daddy only knew, he'd probably kill her. Joni, the Jehovah Witness stripper. I'm gonna try a solo. If you ask her why she does it, she looks at it this way. She says, I'm counting my blessings every night when I get paid. She once lived in poverty and now everything's alright. The Lord showed her how to make $1,000 a night. Joni, the Jehovah Witness stripper, put $1 in her G-string and she'll deliver. If her daddy only knew, he'd probably kill her. Joni, the Jehovah Witness stripper. I don't really have a story for this song. I soaked all your pictures in gasoline. Well, I prayed for a miracle, but the phone never rang. I cried on the front porch and I cursed your name. Well, I waited till sundown, then I lit the flame. Whoa, I'm trying to get over you, but the further away I move, every little bit hurts. Oh, yeah. Every little bit hurts. Ah, yes, it does. I turned on my TV
saw John Wayne kiss his girl goodbye and ride off into the rain. He must not have needed her, 'cause if he did, he would have stayed. He made leaving look easy, but for me, it's not that way. No, I'm trying, trying to get over you. But the further away I move, every little bit hurts. Oh, yeah. Every little bit hurts. Yes, it does. Now, darling, if you're out there listening tonight, I want to let you know one thing. Someday I'll be strong again and won't worship the ground you walk on. No. But, baby, until then, every little bit hurts. Oh, yeah. Every little bit hurts.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Have y'all ever heard that somebody say, give them the roses while they're here? Have you ever heard that? It's a really true thing. You know, we don't tell each other we care about each other enough, it don't seem like, until it's too late sometimes.
Hangs a banner and a thousand red balloons. Today the old man is retiring and the party starts at noon. They're gonna have a celebration. He worked so hard for all those years. You gotta give them their roses while they're here. There's a young girl on the corner. She sells her body for a price. She's got a family back in Texas that don't know where she is tonight. They never showed how much they loved her, so she ran away in tears. You gotta give them their roses while they're here. 'Cause we're not promised tomorrow, so tell the ones you love today just how much you really need them before you know it's too late. You gotta give them the roses while they're here. That's right. Gathered round a marble tombstone with regret in their eyes. They all flew in from different places. They never got to say goodbye. As they walked by and dropped a flower, the wind whispered in their ear, you gotta give them their roses while they're here. 'Cause we're not promised tomorrow, so tell the ones you love today just how much you really need them you know it's too late. You gotta give them their roses while they're here.
All right. I ain't love strange.
Down a strip club, they all know my name. I can't get a woman, so I sit beside the stage. I think Heather really likes me. She wiggles in my face, takes my $40, turns and walks away. Ain't love strange. They honeymooned a week or two until the thrill was gone. Now down the street those newlyweds been fighting all night long. Through a hail of flying dishes the police finally came. They hauled them off in separate cars with cuff and ankle chains. Ain't love strange, ain't love strange, yeah.
It's that simple, y'all can help me.
Ain't love strange, yeah. Ain't love strange.
Now check this part out.
Two gay nympho Quakers on the Jerry Springer show came strutting out in lingerie to let their family know their daddy lost his temper when they walked out on the stage. Their mama said, I love my sons no matter how they've changed. They love strange. 10 roosters in the barnyard and just one little hen. They jockey for position by cock-a-doodling. They flap the wings and strut around. Sometimes they fight all day. Those fresh eggs ain't the only thing that's needing to get laid. They love strange. They love strange. Ain't love strange, yeah. Ain't love strange. I feel like testifying tonight. Now God and mama will love you unconditionally. Your woman will love you if you're faithful. Your dog will love you if you throw him a bone. The devil will love you if you sin. Your children will love you if you buy them some candy. And I will love you if you put on that blue and white polka dot mini skirt with black stiletto heels and just let me sit back and watch you do an interpretive dance to this little groove I got going. Ain't love strange, yeah. Ain't love strange, y'all help me this last time. Ain't love strange, yeah. Ain't love strange.
Thank you very much. This song's called Two Dogs in Heat.
Down, 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 down. Down, 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 down. Here at the Blue Sister, I play my guitar and I watch men and women flirt at the bar. They act like they're in love when they first meet, but deep down they both know they're just two dogs in heat. Two dogs in heat. You're supposed to howl. Yeah. Two dogs in heat. Come on.
It ain't love.
There's nothing more than two dogs in heat. Come on.
All right. That sounded pretty good. But the next time the chorus comes around, I want y'all all to howl without me having to ask you to. It sounds like it's coming instinctive to some of you. I'd also like to say this song is not meant to promote this kind of behavior. Just expose it. I wrote this verse and this next verse in honor of all the ladies for what they have to put up with men sometimes. He took her to a motel where they charged by the hour. And they were having a special, free TV and towels. She had high expectations that they'd make love all night. But it lasted 2 minutes and went out like light. Come on, ladies. Two dogs in heat. It ain't love. It's nothing more than two dogs in heat. Come on. It sound like some of it's coming out of the closet tonight. I know it sounded like I came down real hard on the men in that last verse, exposing their inadequacies. So I'm going to have to say something on their behalf in this last one. So this goes out to all the men tonight for what they have to put up with women sometimes. You wake up. Oh, and by the way, before I say it, I just want to say this didn't happen to me. I just heard about it. All right. All right. You wake up the next morning and you turn on the light. And she don't look as beautiful, you know what I'm gonna say, as she did last night. You tell her you'll call her, but you know it's a lie, 'cause you don't wanna see her again for the rest of your life. Let's turn this thing out tonight. Two dogs in heat. Two dogs in heat. It ain't love. It's nothing more than one more big howl. Two dogs in heat. Thank y'all very much. Paul Thorne. Enjoy. God bless you. Thank you. Appreciate it. Y'all hear one more song tonight. All right. I think everybody's starting to get in the groove tonight. So I tell you what, I'm gonna switch gears a little bit, and I love this next song I'm gonna sing. It's not a song I wrote. I wish it was, because to me it's one of the most beautiful songs that's ever been written. And the kind of church I grew up going to, the style of worship is really, like the music has a heavy beat, and they shout and all that. And so I grew up in that. And so when I sing a gospel song, I like to get in the spirit. So I want y'all to help me get in the spirit tonight. And on the chorus of this song, I want y'all to help me sing it, because it's a good one. Well, I was standing by my window on a cold and cloudy day, when I saw a horse come rolling for to carry my mother away. Help me, people. Will a circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home awaiting.
idea, but I just couldn't. I couldn't hold my sorrow. Yeah, when they lay her in the grave, I feel a thing tonight. Yeah, will the circle be unbroken by and by?
Thank you.